What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brim and Sean, and today we're going to talk about Tekashi 6ix9ine. Now, there's been a lot of videos bringing perspective to Tekashi 6ix9ine's rise. One dope video was Blackie's Why Hip Hop Hates Tekashi 6ix9ine. But I want to talk about something specific because a lot of people have asked me why Tekashi 6ix9ine has been able to blow up and can keep going despite some of the controversy that's been around him. And one of them is something very unusual, and that is how his fan base was built. And a large part of this circles around Fuck Them. Now, if you don't know Fuck Them, if you look at them up on YouTube, you'll see that many of Tekashi 6ix9ine's videos have been posted on Fuck Them. If you're a fan of his, you probably noticed that by now because he consistently is posting on Fuck Them for the most part. I believe even when he posted on Worldstar, he even made a statement that they're still doing videos with Fuck Them. But the point is, Fuck Them is a brand that really historically seemed to serve Eastern Europe and Russia. If you even look at Tekashi's rise, when he started to really do shows, a lot of them were in Russia, they were in Eastern Europe, they were in London and all that kind of stuff. If you look all through last year, it wasn't until December of 2017 that Tekashi 6ix9ine did a show in New York, his hometown. Which brings up a few interesting points. One being, why did they go with Fuck Them as opposed to all the other pages? It's not even like the page was huge back when they started, so I don't know. It's probably more of a personal thing, because how else would you even have known about that page, especially considering the loyalty that they've had to that page? And another thing is actually one of the big things a lot of you have been asking me when we talk about Tekashi 6ix9ine and getting through a lot of this controversy that a lot of people are seeing. When you consider the fact that so much of his fan base has been built overseas first, being built differently than a lot of other upcoming artists like a Trippie Redd or a Triple X, all these people, when his fan base is built over there first, and all of a sudden you start getting a lot of this controversy, a lot of the things that we might see in the news outlets over here, they aren't necessarily being seen and fed in the same way to a lot of his core fan base, because the internet is a little bit segregated. Despite the fact that we do have this worldwide access, there still is a reality that a lot of these pages still tend to be geographical in their primary basis. I talk to artists in other places all the time. I remember talking to some artists in London, and they were talking to me about this huge page that a lot of people post their music to, kind of like a Worldstar, kind of like a Fuck Them, and I never heard of it, but it's typically artists that are in London. So you definitely have to take something like that in account when you think about a Tekashi 6ix9ine, especially since it seems that overseas fan bases are a lot more loyal in comparison to the fickle love you right now, hate you 3 hours later market in the United States. And the last thing to really think about is the interesting path that the team decided to take and why. They were riding the back of Gummo, Kuda, and Kiki before he really hit his hometown in America. It's not that he hadn't done any shows in America at all, but the way they really set it up, it looks like they're hitting America hard as opposed to building up in the same way that a lot of people kind of have to. But they went the hard way first by going overseas, building something really interesting in a lot of places that a lot of these artists can't even touch.
This Thursday, I'm going to be in Poland. This Friday, I'm going to be in Paris, France. And Saturday, I'm in St. Petersburg, Russia. Make sure you're out there, buy your tickets, and pop out. Squat!
So with all that being said, I think this gives Tekashi a really strong foundation in comparison to most of the artists that y'all put on the same level to him, because his fan base is in different places and he has different cores, where a lot of these other artists are dependent on one core and they're still not even strong in that core yet. Tekashi is actually ahead of the game in a lot of ways. Want to know what you guys think about this in the comments, and what do you think that means for his career, and what artists do you even compare to Tekashi personally? Other than that, hit that like button if you like this video. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.